SolarEdge's optimized inverter solution allows installers to build strings of 5,250 watts each. That allows an installer to build over a 10 kilowatt array on just two strings. I'm here with Jeff Morsetti, head of US support for SolarEdge. Jeff, can you talk us through the connections on the SolarEdge inverter?
Sure. To connect the inverter to the AC and DC power sources, SolarEdge provides a safety switch with all the necessary connections. Before wiring the safety switch, we want to verify safety C voltage and polarity. By measuring the voltage on the incoming DC lines, we can check that we have our connections done properly and that the system is wired as expected. Check that the polarity is correct as well. Each optimizer will output 1 volt DC. Each series of optimizers will output a total voltage roughly equal to the number of optimizers. Next, check which version of terminal blocks you have. They are all basically the same with some differences in appearance. For some inverters, the DC terminal blocks look like this. If you see this style of terminal block, you will need to insert the DC wire here while pressing here with a screwdriver. Don't insert the wire here as this will not be a secure connection. For other inverters, the DC terminal blocks look like this. Insert the wire here while pressing down on the screwdriver here. For the high power AC terminal blocks, you will need to rotate the screwdriver counterclockwise here and insert the wire here. So let's walk through these connections. First, connect the AC wires. Strip the wire ends about 1 3/8 inch. Connect the grounding wire first. The 3 to 6 kilowatt inverters are different than the high power inverters, so pay attention to the labeling. Connect the DC equipment ground conductor to the equipment grounding terminal blocks in the AC-DC safety switch. Connect the DC wires from the PV insulation to the DC positive and DC negative terminal blocks. Use a standard straight-bladed screwdriver to connect the wires to the spring clamp terminals. Insert the wire fully. No exposed copper should be showing.
Thank you for joining us today at the SolarEdge University, and stay tuned for more how-to videos from SolarEdge.